Yes, sir.
Yeah. In this question, it is given that instead of defining one AMU as 1/12 the mass of carbon atom, if I define it as 1/5 the mass of carbon atom, what would be the mass of nitrogen on the new scale? Okay, that's the question. Irrespective of the nature of the scale, the mass of the carbon atom, the absolute mass of it, won't be changing. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay, so initially it is defined as 1/12 the mass of carbon atom. Now I'm defining it as 1/5 the mass of the carbon atom. The mass of the carbon atom, the absolute mass of it, won't be changing. Hence, I'm dividing both of these. So u dash upon u, क्या हुआ? 1/5 अपॉन 1/12 और u dash और u के बीच में रिलेशन, u dash is equals to 12/5 times u और u is equals to 5/12 times u dash. We got the relation between the new scale and the old scale. Agreed? यहाँ तक क्लियर है? On the conventional scale मतलब the original scale, which is 1/12 the mass of the carbon atom. On that scale, it is 14, मतलब 14 new है. Okay? You need to get the answer in terms of the new scale. New scale में what is the relation between u and u dash? U is equals to 5/12 times u dash. So वो substitute किया मैंने. Scale, it is 5.83 times of u dash. मतलब 5.83 into 1/5 times mass of carbon 12 atom. Okay? This 5.83 into 1/12 times, sorry, 1/5 times mass of carbon 12 atom will be equal to 14 into 14 u है ना, 14 into 1/12 times mass of carbon atom होगा. और दोनों सेम रहेगा, और दोनों वैल्यूज. ये क्या है? दिस इज 5.83 u डैश, which is 5.83 into 1/5 mass of carbon 12. ओरिजिनल स्केल में 14 into 1/12 टाइम्स मास ऑफ कार्बन 12. कैलकुलेट दिस, 5.83 अपॉन 5 और 4 अपॉन 12, 14 अपॉन 12, बोथ ऑफ देम विल बी द सेम वैल्यू. ये भी आना चाहिए ना?
यस सर,
ये एक्स्ट्रा इंफॉर्मेशन आपको बता रहा हूँ. यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन हो गया फर्दर क्रॉस चेकिंग के लिए. ओके, बोथ द स्केल्स मस्ट लीड टू द सेम मास ऑन सेम मास विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द मास ऑफ कार्बन 12. सेम मल्टीपल आना चाहिए. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. स्मिथ, इज दैट क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके ओके. इसी में एवरीवन लुक एट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. ये क्वेश्चन हमने डिस्कस नहीं किया ना. आई थिंक दिस क्वेश्चंस वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. Excuse me. If we consider 1/6 in place of 1/12, 1/6 in place of 1/12, mass of carbon atom is taken to be relative. Okay, relative mass unit. The mass of 1 mole of substance will be. They're asking what would be the mass of 1 mole of substance. Instead of taking 1/12, I'm defining it as 1/6. Mass of carbon atom, what would be the mass of 1 mole of any substance? What will happen to the mass of 1 mole of any substance? What is the answer for this?
It will not change.
It will not change. इसको हमने प्रूव भी किया है. they are asking about the mass, the absolute mass of it in terms of grams. If I'm calculating that in terms of grams, it won't be changing. Okay. मतलब क्या है? Suppose again u dash, what is u dash? It is 1/6 into mass of carbon 12. What is u? 1/12 into mass of carbon 12. What is u dash upon u? 1/6 upon 1/12, which is equal to 2. और u dash क्या हो गया? 2u हो गया. Agreed?
Yes, okay. Sir.
What is mass of any substance? Na, I am taking, suppose maan lete, I am taking mass of nitrogen only. Mass of nitrogen atom. पुराने स्केल में कितना है? 14u. On new scale. Mass कितना हो जाएगा? 14 into u के प्लेस में I can substitute u dash upon 2. 2 or 14 cancel. Okay, 7u dash आया. What is this? This is the atomic mass of nitrogen on the new scale. Okay, this is mass of one atom on new scale. ओके यहाँ पे थोड़ा अरेज कर रहा हूं मैं. व्हाट इज मास ऑफ वन मोल ऑफ नाइट्रोजन विच इज इक्वल टू एटॉमिक मास 7u इनटू वन मोल. एक एटम का मास है 7u. वन मोल एटम्स का मास कितना होगा? वन मोल इंटू 7u. एनी डाउट?
नो सर.
ओके, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन ओरिजिनल एएमयू ग्राम एंड मोल? वन एएमयू इज इक्वल्स टू 1 g/mol. एग्रीड? वन एएमयू इज इक्वल्स टू 1 g/mol. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ मोल, दिस इंप्लाइज मोल इक्वल्स टू 1 g अपॉन एएमयू. So in place of mole, can I substitute gram upon AMU? But ये तो U dash में है, ये तो U में है. If I want to get everything in terms of grams, convert U dash into U. What is the relation between them? U dash equal to 2U na? 7 into 2U into gram per U. UU cancel होगा. कितना आया? 14 g. अभी भी कितना आया? 14 g से आया ना?
Yes sir.
Irrespective of the scale, one mole substance, उसका mass कितना है? Absolute mass कितना है? Grams में calculate कर रहे थे. It is 14 g only. So what has happened to the mass? It remain unchanged. Agreed? Once look at the solving part. Initially, I have calculated atomic mass. If I want to find the atomic mass, it has become 7u. On the new scale, it got changed. If I want to have the absolute value of it, the mass of the atom won't be changing. Okay. In terms of new scale, it appears to be 7u. So if I'm calculating for 1 mole of the substance, it is 7u times 1 mole. I'm trying to calculate the mass in terms of grams. So I have substituted in place of mole as gram per AMU. The relation between AMU and U dash is U dash equals to 2U. So calculate करने से आपको फिर से 14 g ही आया. आया समझ में? Okay.
Sir, what is meaning of increase twofold?
Twofold मतलब 2 times हो गया. Increase twofold मतलब initially 14 g है तो अब 28 g हो गया. Threefold मतलब 3 times हुआ. Decrease twice और decrease twofold करके भी बोल सकते हो. यहाँ पे decreased by twice. increase by twice, you can call this as increase twice or increase twofold. Clear? Yes. Okay. I think last मैं आपको कुछ क्वेश्चंस दिया है होमवर्क के लिए. हैव यू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चंस? व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पेज ऑफ क्विकली मैं आपको सॉल्यूशंस बता देता हूं, किसी को कुछ डाउट है तो बता देना मुझे. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पेज ऑफ गैसेस कंटेन्स द सेम नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स. हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स? इट इज नथिंग बट सैंपल मास अपॉन मॉलिक्युलर मास. Initially, O2 molecules. If I want to find number of O2 molecules, and now O2 equals to, uska sample mass 16 gram. What is the molecular weight of O2? It is 32 gram per mole.
Yes.
32 mu or 32 gram per mole. Kitna hua? Half mole hua. Okay. N2 ka number of moles of N2. Will be equal to 14 gram divided by N2 mass is 28 gram per mole, which is again equal to half mole. So 16 gram of O2 may be aapko half mole of O2 molecule se, 14 gram of N2 may be aapko half mole of N2 molecule se. So option A has to be the right answer. Agreed? Which of the following pairs of gases contains the same number of molecules? So answer is option A. बाकी भी एक बार चेक कर ले क्या. 8 ग्राम्स ऑफ O2 मतलब मोल्स कितना रहेगा?
1/4
मोल. ओके. 22 ग्राम्स ऑफ CO2 मतलब मोल्स कितना होगा?
हाफ
बिकॉज़ CO2 मास इज 44 ग्राम पर मोल. ओके. 22 अपॉन 44 इट इज हाफ. एनी डाउट एनीवन?
नो.
ओके. यहाँ पे 1/4 थे, यहाँ पे हाफ है. 28 ग्राम ऑफ N2. 28 ग्राम ऑफ N2 मतलब आपको फिर से 14 अपॉन 28 विच इज हाफ मोल. 22 ग्राम ऑफ CO2 दिस इज आल्सो हाफ मोल ना?
यस सर.
दिस इज आल्सो हाफ मोल. सो यहाँ पे भी आपको व्हाट इज द मास? नो नो. 28 ग्राम ऑफ N2 मतलब आप
1 मोल.
ओके. दिस इज 1 मोल. 28 अपॉन 28 विच इज 1 मोल. 22 ग्राम ऑफ CO2 मतलब आपको हाफ मोल. ओके.
यस सर.
ठीक. 32 ग्राम ऑफ O2 एंड 32 ग्राम ऑफ N2. 32 ग्राम ऑफ O2 मतलब आपको 1 मोल हो गया. 32 ग्राम ऑफ N2 मतलब आपको 32 अपॉन 28 मोल हुआ. ओके. क्लियरली दे आर डिफरेंट, दे आर नॉट द सेम. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. द नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स प्रेजेंट इन 25.6 ग्राम्स ऑफ सुक्रोज which has molar mass of 342.3 grams is. What are number of sucrose molecules? N of C12H22O11. Number of sucrose molecules kitna rahenge? Uska sample mass 25.6 divided by molecular mass 342.3. Kuch cancel hoga kya ye? ये ग्राम डिवाइडेड बाय ग्राम पर मोल. आप लोग ने सॉल्व किया ये क्वेश्चन?
यस सर.
ओके. व्हाट इज 25.6 डिवाइडेड बाय 342.3?
इट कम्स अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1/13.
अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1/13. 15. ओके.
13.
Okay, okay, 13. Okay. The exact value of it, 0.0747 hai kuch.
Haan, sir, 7.
Okay. The exact value of it, if you use calculator, you will get 0.07478 aisa kuch hai. You can approximately take that equal to 0.075 mole. Okay. They're asking the number of hydrogen atoms. In one molecule of sucrose, how many hydrogen atoms are there?
22.
So these many moles mein number of hydrogen atoms kitna ho jayega?
22 into 0.075.
आंसर मोल में नहीं दिया है, सो आई विल मल्टीप्लाई दैट विद 6.022 × 10^23. एनी डाउट एनीवन? दिस इज द फाइनल आंसर. ओके, प्लीज मल्टीप्लाई एंड क्रॉस चेक विद द ऑप्शंस. एनी डाउट? सबसे पहले इफ यू आर गिवन द सैंपल मास ऑफ सुक्रोज, यू कैन ओनली कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ सुक्रोज. Once you get the number of molecules by analysis of the formula, each formula unit is having 22 atoms of hydrogen. So these many moles will be having 22 into 0.075 mole of hydrogen atoms. Any doubt?
No,
sir.
You can expect these questions in your first level exams like NEET, CET, JEE mains mein bhi kabhi kabhi aa sakta hai. You may need to compare different samples and you need to tell me which particular sample is having greater number of molecules or greater number of atoms. Aisa questions aa sakta hai. Aapko bas compare karna hai us case mein, so no need to do the entire calculation. Is case mein to aapko karna padega. You need to multiply this and you will get the entire answer. Question number 3. The most abundant elements by mass in the body of a healthy human adult are oxygen, which contributes to 61.4%, carbon 22.9%, hydrogen 10%, and nitrogen 2.6%. The weight which a 75 kg person would gain if all the hydrogen atoms are replaced by one H2 atoms. Hydrogen atoms matlab kya hoga? हाइड्रोजन एटम्स मतलब 1H1 है, नाउ दे आर बीइंग रिप्लेस्ड बाय 1H2. 1H1 इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोटियम, इट इज द आइसोटोप ऑफ हाइड्रोजन विच इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोटियम विच इज द नॉर्मल हाइड्रोजन. 1H2 इज कॉल्ड एज ड्यूटेरियम. ओके, व्हाट इज वन एटम ऑफ प्रोटियम? What is the mass of one atom of protium? It is 1 mu. One atom of deuterium is 2 mu. Now what you are doing, 75 kgs mein hydrogen ka contribution kitna hai mass mein? It is 7.5 kg. 10% hai na?
So
the hydrogen's mass inside the 75 kg person is 7.5 kg. You are replacing the entire of hydrogen by 1H2. मतलब 1U को निकाल के आप लोग 2U ऐड कर रहे हैं, सो यू आर एडिंग 1 more AMU, राइट? बाय रिप्लेसिंग 1H1 बाय 1H2 यू आर एडिंग 1 AMU. एग्रीड?
यस.
ओके, सो इफ आई रिप्लेस 7.5 kg एक्स्ट्रा और कितना ऐड करूंगा? व्हेनेवर आई एम रिप्लेसिंग इट बाय ड्यूटेरियम, एक्स्ट्रा अमाउंट ऑफ मास दैट आई विल बी एडिंग इज हाउ मच?
7.5
kg only.
7.5.
Okay, total that I am going to add is 15 kg, but 75 kgs mein se first you are removing 7.5 kg. Okay, deuterium's mass is twice the mass of hydrogen, so whenever you are adding deuterium you are adding 15 kg. So net mein aap log kitna add kiya hai?
7.5.
You are adding only 7.5 kg. I hope this is clear.
Yes.
Okay. So the weight gained by 75 kg person is 7.5 kg. It is not 15 kg. It is 7.5 kg. I hope this is clear. Okay. Question number 3 ka solution hai ye. Okay, question number 4. How many moles of magnesium phosphate? The formula is Mg3PO4 twice will contain 0.25 mole of oxygen atoms. Suppose wo log ne formula nahi diya aapko, magnesium phosphate ka formula nahi diya. I hope everyone knows how to form the formula. Magnesium. What is the usual oxidation state of magnesium? It is plus 2. Phosphate. आप लोग रेडिकल्स के बारे में पढ़ा होगा इन योर 10th और 9th. Phosphate is PO4 3-. How to form the formula? ये जो है पार्ट यहाँ पे जाएगा, ये 3 जो है यहाँ पे जाएगा. So the formula will become Mg3PO4 2. Or else in any particular molecule, the net charge has to be neutral. If this is a neutral molecule, magnesium phosphate, net charge balance होना चाहिए आपको. Net positive charge must be equal to the net negative charge. अगर ये plus 2 है, ये minus 3 है. बैलेंस करने के लिए इसको 3 से मल्टीप्लाई करो, आप लोग को प्लस 6 चार्ज आएगा. इसको 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करो, आपको माइनस 6 चार्ज आएगा. सो प्लस 6 एंड माइनस 6 गॉट बैलेंस्ड. इसलिए वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय 3, वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय 2. एग्रीड एवरीवन? इज दैट क्लियर? So the formula becomes Mg3PO4 2. They're asking how many moles of magnesium phosphate will have 0.25 mole of oxygen atoms. If I take 1 mole of magnesium phosphate, Mg3PO4 2, what are the moles of oxygen we have?
8
mole. Everyone, is that clear? In 1 mole, you have 8 moles of oxygen atoms. How many oxygen atoms do you need? You require only 0.25 mole. उसके लिए कितना लगेगा? यही है ना क्वेश्चन? अगर यू हैव 8 मोल्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम्स इन 1 मोल ऑफ Mg3PO4 2, 0.25 मोल्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम्स विल बी प्रेजेंट इन हाउ मच अमाउंट? आंसर विल बी इक्वल टू यूनिटरी मेथड 0.25 अपॉन 8 इनटू 1 विच इज इक्वल टू 1/32 ना? So answer is 1/32 mole. Okay. 1/32 मतलब आपको हो जाएगा 0.03125.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Which is 3.125 × 10⁻². I can write this as 3.125 × 10⁻². Is that clear? Okay. Students who are hearing this for the second time, don't feel bored. Take this as a practice. Okay. Question number 5. A sample of ammonium phosphate contains 3.18 moles of hydrogen atoms. The number of moles of oxygen atoms in the sample is. Okay. How to solve this question? Anyone? How to solve this question? Ammonium phosphate दिया है कुछ तो sample. उस sample में 3.18 moles of hydrogen atoms है. They are asking number of moles of oxygen. क्या मित्राज?
Yes sir, can I answer?
Yeah yeah, man, go ahead.
हाँ sir, तो इसमें इसको sir हम 2 step में solve कर सकते हैं.
Okay.
First of all, हम देख सकते हैं कि लाइक 1 मोल ऑफ अगर हमारे पास अमोनियम फास्फेट होगा सो इट विल हैव 12 मोल ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स.
बिल्कुल सही एवरीवन, ये सही है ना? किसी को कुछ डाउट? इफ आई टेक 1 मोल ऑफ अमोनियम फास्फेट इन दैट आई हैव 12 मोल ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स. ओके गो अहेड अमितराज. हाँ मित्राज बोलो.
हाँ सर, सो फॉर हाउ मेनी मोल्स ऑफ अमोनियम फास्फेट वी विल गेट 3.18 मोल्स ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स. वी विल सॉल्व दैट एंड वी विल गेट दैट वैल्यू फर्स्ट.
okay, which is equal to 3.18 divided by 12 into 1 mole. Agreed? What is this? This is the amount of ammonium phosphate. Okay, they're asking the number of oxygen atoms in this particular sample. Kitne rahenge? Sorry.
3 into 3.18 by 12 into 1.
Okay, I need to multiply that by 3. Number of oxygen atoms. Sorry, I need to multiply by 4. Number of oxygen atoms will be equal to 1 mole mein aapko, you have 4 mole of oxygen atoms. In these many moles, how many oxygen atoms will be present? 3.18 divided by 12 mole into 4, which is equal to 3.18 divided by 3. कितना है वो 1.06 राइट
यस सर
आई होप दिस इज क्लियर ओके नेक्स्ट लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन व्हिच इज एनालाइजिंग केमिकल रिएक्शंस एवरीवन प्लीज पुट योर वीडियो ऑन लेट्स एनालाइज केमिकल रिएक्शंस First of all, let us understand what is meant by a chemical reaction. What actually happens in chemical reaction is there is rearrangement of atoms between various molecules, which are called as reactants, to give new set of molecules, which are called as products. Whenever you have a chemical reaction, I will write a chemical reaction here. Example, if I take Suppose carbon is reacting with oxygen or thoda bada equation likhte hai. You have HCl. I am reacting that with NaOH, which is an acid-base reaction. And the products formed are H2O plus NaCl, salt and water. This is a typical neutralization reaction. Whenever an acid combines with a base, the reaction is called as neutralization. And the products are salt and water. NaCl is the salt, H2O is the water. So what is happening in this reaction? There is just rearrangement of atoms. Yahan pe jo hydrogen hai, that hydrogen got transferred to this particular OH and this Cl got transferred to Na. As a result, we got H2O and NaCl. Agreed? So what has happened? There is simply rearrangement of atoms among different molecules, which are called as reactants, to form new set of molecules, which are called as products. So in any chemical reaction, there is simply rearrangement of atoms. As there is only rearrangement of atoms, can I say in any chemical reaction, there has to be conservation of atoms?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Agreed? If there is conservation of atoms, can I say there has to be conservation of mass also?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? So, in order to classify a given reaction as a chemical reaction, you need to see these two. There has to be conservation of atoms and there has to be conservation of mass. If there is conservation of atoms, obviously the mass will be conserved. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Clear? Okay. वही यहाँ पे लिखा है सिंस द एटम्स आर ओनली रीअरेंज्ड दे रिमेन कंजर्व्ड देयरफॉर देयर मास इज आल्सो कंजर्व्ड ओके नेक्स्ट साइड हेडिंग स्टोइकियोमेट्री व्हाट इज मीन बाय स्टोइकियोमेट्री इट इज नथिंग बट स्टडी ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड कैलकुलेशंस रिलेटेड टू इट कैलकुलेशंस रिलेटेड टू इट का मतलब क्या है इस केस में वी विल बी डूइंग सम कैलकुलेशंस लाइक वी विल बी टेकिंग सम अमाउंट ऑफ HCl सम x ग्राम्स ऑफ HCl We will be reacting it with some y grams of NaOH and we need to analyze how many grams of H2O and how many grams of NaCl are produced. Okay. those are some of the typical stoichiometric calculations. Stoichiometry is nothing but it is the study of chemical reactions and calculations associated to them. We may need to calculate the number of molecules of HCl that are going to react with some Y molecules of NaOH to form some Z molecules of H2O and some N molecules of NaCl. Okay, or else the mass of HCl that we need to take in order to react with some given amount of NaOH. Is that clear? So, ye calculations sab kuch hum dekhne wale hai. So, before going into that, let us understand all the terms involved in a chemical reaction. For example, I'm taking a reaction SO2 plus O2 gives rise to SO3. Sulfur dioxide combining with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide. If you want to analyze any chemical reaction, first you need to balance the reaction. Okay. Yahan pe SO2 plus O2 gives rise to SO3 hai. If I multiply this O2 by half, can I say the equation is balanced? यहाँ पे सल्फर एक है, यहाँ पे भी एक है, ऑक्सीजन यहाँ पे दो, हाफ ऑफ O2 मतलब नेट में एक ही ऑक्सीजन है, एग्रीड? सो 2 + 1 आपको 3 है, यहाँ पे भी आपको 3 है, इज दैट क्लियर? ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ बैलेंस्ड केमिकल इक्वेशन, एंड इस बैलेंस्ड इक्वेशन में जो भी कोफिशिएंट्स है 1 SO2 प्लस half O2 gives rise to 1 SO3. The coefficients are 1, half and 1. These coefficients are called as stoichiometric coefficients. What are stoichiometric coefficients? The coefficients of the reactants and products that are appearing in a balanced chemical equation, they are called as stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, we need to understand what does these stoichiometric coefficients represent. Do they represent the amount in mass, or do they represent the amount in molecules, or do they represent the amount in moles? We need to understand these three. What does the stoichiometric coefficients represent? First question, we will understand, do they represent amount in mass? Iska matlab kya hai? What do I mean by this? If I write the equation 1 SO2 plus half O2 gives rise to 1 SO3. If I'm saying that the stoichiometric coefficients represent the amount in mass, can I say 1 gram of SO2 is reacting with half gram of O2 to form 1 gram of SO3? Everyone, please put your video on. Okay. The first question I'm trying to address is, do stoichiometric coefficients represent the amount in mass? If they are representing the amount in mass, I can say that 1 gram of SO2 is reacting with half gram of O2 to form 1 gram of SO3. Or else I can say, if I start with 1 gram of SO2 in the laboratory, I will be reacting with that with half gram of O2 and I need to form 1 gram of SO3. Is this valid or not? We need to check. If this is a chemical equation, it should satisfy conservation of mass.
Yes, sir.
If I'm taking 1 gram and if I'm reacting that with half gram, how much amount I need to produce as per the definition of chemical reaction? I need to produce 1.5 gram.
Yes,
1.5 gram. But yahan pe humko kitna aa raha
hai? 1 gram hi
aa raha hai. So do stoichiometric coefficients represent the amount in mass?
No, sir.
Okay, no. Agreed? Because there is no conservation of mass here. On the left hand side, on the right hand side, the mass is different. So the stoichiometric coefficients do not represent the amount in mass. Next, let us understand if they represent the amount in molecules. Do they represent number of molecules? Again, I'm taking the same equation. 1SO2 plus half O2 gives rise to 1SO3. If they represent the amount in terms of number of molecules, can I say one molecule of SO2 is reacting with half molecule of O2 to form one molecule of SO3? Agreed? Yes, if they are representing the amount in terms of molecules, what I need to check? I need to check for the conservation of mass. If there is conservation of mass, then that is valid. Agreed? Tell me the mass of molecule of SO2. Everyone, please participate. Tell me the mass of one molecule of SO2. सल्फर का 32 है, ऑक्सीजन का 16 है, दो ऑक्सीजन से, सो 32 प्लस 32 64 mu. व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ हाफ मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ O2?
8
mu.
वंस अगेन 16 mu.
16.
O2 का मास 32 है, हाफ ऑफ दैट विल बी 16 mu, नॉट 8. Okay, half molecule of O2. What is the mass of one molecule of SO3? 32 plus 48. 32 plus 48 kitna hai?
80.
80 mu. Okay, so left hand side mein 64 u plus 16 u, which is equals to 80 u. Ye satisfy kiya na?
Yes.
Iska matlab, can they represent the amount in molecules?
Yes.
They can definitely do that, but in this particular case mein, you should not say it has the amount in molecules. The reason is we have written it half molecule of O2. If I ask you to bring half molecule of O2 to laboratory, you can never do that. Aadha molecule kabhi exist nahi hota hai. Everyone understand this. Half molecule doesn't exist. So if I write the equation as SO2 plus half O2 gives rise to SO3. Even though it is satisfying with respect to mass, conservation of mass, we can never bring half molecule of O2. So in this case, in this particular scenario, I will say no. The reason is half molecule of O2 doesn't exist. Suppose if I write the equation as, I'm not writing that as 1SO2 plus half O2. I am writing that as 2SO2 plus O2 gives rise to 2SO3. In this case, two molecules of SO2 are reacting with one molecule of O2 to form two molecules of SO3. This will be valid because two molecules of SO2. What would be the mass? It is 128 mu. O2 ka mass 32 mu, which is equal to two molecules of SO3. It is equal to 160 mu. Ye satisfy kiya hai. And moreover, we can definitely have one molecule and two molecules. So in the laboratory, I can do the reaction between two molecules of SO2 and one molecule of O2, and I will definitely form two molecules of SO3. So this is a valid representation. So the stoichiometric coefficients can represent the amount in terms of molecules if and only if the coefficients are not fractions. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Sure.
They may ask which of the following equations is a right representation. If they are saying one molecule SO2 is reacting with half molecule O2 to form one molecule SO3, it is a wrong representation. Yes, Smith, tell me.
Sir, mentioned real, it can't happen. Okay, just only from O2 molecule, just only one O took part in a reaction and other O doesn't, it means.
This cannot happen that way. Half molecule jaisa bolna galat hai. You can take one O2 whenever you are taking the, once again, please ask me, the, repeat the question, Smith.
No, means in real, it can't happen, no, that from O2 molecule, only one O atom has took part in a reaction.
That can happen if I am taking one O2 molecule. I am taking one O2 molecule, one O can react with it. But yahan pe representation mein, ye likhne ka matlab kya hua? Half molecule lena. Half molecule, I cannot form it, right? If I am taking one O atom, I need to write that as what? I need to write that as one oxygen atom. If you are taking it as O2, you are taking O2 molecule, na?
Sir, no, but one O from that whole O2 is taking part in the action.
Yeah, way. One O, yahan pe bhi wahi ho raha hai. Isme do oxygens mein se ek oxygen SO2 ke ja raha hai, ek SO2 ke saath. Dusra oxygen dusra SO2 ke saath ja raha hai. But ye sab bolna, हाफ O2 करके लिखना ये गलत होगा करके बोल रहा हूँ क्योंकि आधा मॉलिक्यूल ये पूरा मॉलिक्यूल मान लेते हैं ऐसा आधा नहीं ले सकते हम हाफ मॉलिक्यूल नॉट नेसेसरली मीन वन ऑक्सीजन एटम ये दोनों बराबर नहीं है हाफ मॉलिक्यूल वन ऑक्सीजन एटम नहीं होता है हाफ मॉलिक्यूल जैसे एग्जिस्ट ही नहीं होता है वैसा बोल रहा हूँ
Okay, sir, but if we want to say one oxygen atom, then...
you need to write that as one O. You should not write that as half O2.
Okay, okay sir, you but we can use only one O.
You can use one O, but you don't get one O in nature, na? If I want to form SO3 in laboratory, I will be taking O2 molecule. How can I get one O? Because atmosphere mein O2 jaisa hai wo. Samjha?
Yes, sir.
I hope this is clear. Everyone, baki log. Okay. Next, try to understand. Do they represent number of moles? Do they represent number of moles? Again, let's take the first equation. One SO2 plus half O2 gives rise to one SO3. If they are representing number of moles, I can say one mole of SO2 is reacting with half mole of O2 to form one mole of SO3. Let us see conservation of mass. One mole of SO2 ka mass kitna hoga? It is 64
gram per mole.
Gram per mole into mole na?
Yes sir.
Ek ka mass 64 mu hai. One mole ka mass 64 gram per mole into mole. We will get the same answer in terms of grams. ओके हाफ मोल का मास कितना होगा आई एम डायरेक्टली राइटिंग दैट 16 ग्राम्स वन मोल ऑफ SO3 का मास कितना रहेगा 80 ग्राम्स अगेन सी देयर इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास एग्रीड इन दिस केस द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ दीज स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट्स एज मोल्स इज एप्रोप्रिएट द रीजन इज I can have half mole of oxygen atoms. I can bring in laboratory half mole of oxygen molecules. Matlab kya hai? One mole matlab kya hai? 6.022 into 10 part 23 SO2 molecules ko. Half mole matlab?
3.01.
0.011 into 10 part 23 oxygen molecules. I can bring them na. Half molecule ko leke aana mushkil hai, but this is not fraction. This is some number. Into 10 part 23 matlab 0000 aayega na. Those many number of oxygen molecules I can bring. None of the oxygen molecules are in fraction then. Okay, those are complete molecules. I can bring them. So this is possible. Again, one mole matlab, I will be forming 6.022 into 10 part 23 SO3 molecules. Agreed? So the stoichiometric coefficient can definitely represent the amount in terms of moles, even though they are fractions. You can see these equations. Aisa equations aapko book mein bhi dikhega. You should not say, in that particular case, one molecule will be reacting with half molecule. You can definitely say one mole will react with half mole. Because there is existence of half mole. There is no existence of half molecule. I hope this is clear. Yes. Everyone, please put your video on. I can see only one girl. Baki sab log on. Video off. Yeah. Okay. No matter how bored you are, please don't put your video off. Okay.
Sir.
Clear?
Sir.
Yeah, Smith, bolo.
Sir, if we can't have half molecule of oxygen, means then why we are writing such reaction?
Isliye aisa likhna nahi chahiye karke bol raha hu. If you are writing this equation.
For gram second we took for calculating if grams is correct.
Nahi, nahi. Half mole can exist, Smith. Half molecule cannot exist. Isliye, if I'm writing this equation, I should never say one molecule is reacting with half molecule. I can definitely say one mole will react with half mole. Kyunki half mole exist kar sakta hai na, Smith. 3.011 into 10 power 23. It is not fraction of molecules. It is some integer molecules. Agreed, Smith?
Yes, sir. No, but if such reaction is only not possible, then why to calculate if it is right in terms of mole and that?
Once again, Smith.
Sir, if reaction is only means writing like half O2 is only not right, then why we are means
half O2 will be right. With half O2 is right if I say it is half mole. If the stoichiometric coefficient here is not molecules, it is moles of molecules, then it is right. If I am saying that this stoichiometric coefficient is molecule, matlab half molecule, then it is wrong. So it all depends upon what you are representing. If the stoichiometric coefficients represents molecules, then I should never write that as fraction. Because half molecule doesn't exist. Okay. If yes. The stoichiometric coefficients are fractions, then I should definitely say these are moles. As a bol raha hu main. So the stoichiometric coefficient, you can definitely say, if this is the stoichiometric coefficient, I can definitely say in the laboratory, if I start with two molecules of O2, two molecules of SO2 and one molecule of O2, I will definitely get two molecules of SO3. No doubt in that. Okay. If I start with one mole of SO2 and half mole of O2, I will definitely get one mole of SO3. There is no doubt in that. Yahan pe also you can say, if I start with one molecule of SO2 and half molecule of O2, I can get one molecule. But you need to bring me in the laboratory half molecule of O2, which you can never do that. A reaction karne ke liye laboratory mein, tumko aadha molecule O2 leke aana padega na mere paas. What is the significance of half molecule? There is no logical meaning to that. Vaisa bata raha hu main. That's what I'm trying to convey. Clear hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the stoichiometric coefficients, they may represent number of molecules, provided they are not fractions. They can always represent number of moles. Clear hai? Done?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, next definition before analyzing the chemical reactions. Next definition, limiting reagent and excess reagent. See the definitions. the reactant that gets exhausted first and limits the reaction is called as limiting reagent. Excess reagent matlab, it is that reagent that is left at the end of the reaction. Again, let's try to analyze this. Let's take the same reaction. Aapko 2SO2 plus O2 gives rise to 2SO3. I am taking this reaction. What does the stoichiometric coefficients represent? They may represent the number of molecules or they may represent the number of moles. Okay, I can say 2 mole of SO2 will definitely react with 1 mole of O2 and they will definitely produce 2 mole of SO3. Agreed? Okay, but what I'm doing is initial amount. What I'm doing is I'm taking 4 mole of SO2, but I'm taking only 1.5 mole of O2. I'm reacting 4 mole of SO2 with 1.5 mole of O2. What is going to happen? From the stoichiometry, if I take 2 mole, I am requiring 1 mole of O2. So if I take 4 mole of SO2, how many moles of O2 will be required?
2 moles.
But humne kitna liya hai? 1.5 liya hai. Is matlab, am I able to react the entire amount of SO2? Matlab sara 4 mole consume ho pa rahe kya?
No, sir.
The reason is we don't have 2 mole of O2. Okay. Or else ऐसा कुछ कर सकते हैं हम फ्रॉम स्टोइकोमेट्री. और फ्रॉम स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट्स व्हाट कैन आई कमेंट 1 मोल O2 फॉर कंप्लीट रिएक्शन इट रिक्वायर 2 मोल ऑफ SO2. So 1.5 mole O2 ke liye SO2 kitna lagega? Use unitary method and calculate. It is 1.5 upon 1 into 2 mole.
Sir, 3.
Which is equal to 3 mole. Okay. So SO2 left. After reaction, kitna hai?
1 mole.
It is 4 mole minus 3 mole, which is equals to 1 mole. So in this particular question or in this particular reaction, SO2 will be called as excess reagent. Because even after the completion of reaction, you are left with some amount of SO2. Or I'm saying that that particular SO2 is taken in excess. Hence, it is called as excess reagent. Ye jo particular SO2, kis wajah se bacha? That is because of completion of O2, na?
Yes.
Agar O2 sufficient amount mein rehta, toh pura SO2 bhi consume ho jata. Because of completion of O2 first, that SO2 got left. Hence, that O2 is called as limiting reagent. Uske wajah se reaction ruk gaya. Nahi toh pura ho jata. Samjha?
Yes,
if O2 is available in sufficient amount, the entire SO2 will be consumed. As O2 is present in insufficient amount, some of the SO2 got left. Hence, that particular O2 is called as limiting reagent. Uske wajah se reaction limit hua. And SO2, as SO2 is left at the end of the reaction, it is called as excess reagent. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So usually complete reaction hone ke liye, matlab if all of the reactants must be consumed, what you should do? You should take them in stoichiometric proportions. Matlab you need to always take SO2 and O2 in 2:1 ratio in order to have complete reaction. If you are taking that in any other ratio, always you will be having one excess reagent and one limiting reagent. Agreed?
Yes.
Everyone, mathematics. Okay, if you take this in 2:1, then it is going to react completely. यहाँ पे ratio क्या है? ये 4 है, ये 3/2 है. The ratio is not 2:1. Okay. Clear? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So in this, SO2 जो है, this is called as excess reagent denoted by ER. O2 is called as limiting reagent denoted by LR. Okay. I have given you a question here. You need to analyze which is the excess reagent and which is the limiting reagent. All the students who have already attended the lecture, please don't answer. Give chance to the new students. यहाँ पे आपको A और B दिया है. The initial moles taken. Initial indicates this is the amount taken in the container for the reaction. 9 mole of A are taken, 27 mole of B are taken. You need to tell me which is the excess reagent. And you need to also calculate how much of the limiting reagent that is going to be left, how much of the product C and D are going to be produced. Kitna C or D banega because of this particular reaction. Agar koi excess reagent hai to, woh kitna bachega. Everyone try, कोशिश करो, देखते हैं. Yeah, answer anyone? Any new student, please answer. Smith, yeah, Ishita, yeah, Riya. देखो इन क्वेश्चंस के लिए अप्रोच कैसे करेंगे. इफ यू आर अनेबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हिच इज द लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट, एज्यूम वन ऑफ द रिएजेंट आउट ऑफ दीज टू, एज्यूम वन ऑफ द रिएजेंट एज लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट. सपोज इस क्वेश्चन के लिए आई एम एज्यूमिंग. एवरीवन इन द लेक्चर?
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके, आई एम एज्यूमिंग, एज्यूम बी एज limiting reagent. What is meant by limiting reagent? The one which is going to be consumed entirely. Wo pura khatam ho jayega. Agreed?
Yes.
Okay. So if B is limiting reagent, entire 27 mole of it must be consumed?
Yes.
Right? Okay. So as per stoichiometry, everyone observe the stoichiometry. According to given equation or given stoichiometric equation, I can say 6 mole B require how many mole of A?
3.
Sorry. Require 3 mole A. So I need to now react 27 mole B. 27 mole B ke liye A kitna lagega? Unitary method. 27 upon 6 into 3, which is equal to how much?
13.5.
13.5 mole of A. Do we have 13.5 mole of A?
No.
We have only 9 mole, na? The amount yes. taken is only 9 mole. Iska matlab kya hua? Hamara assumption jo hai wo galat hua. Okay. We have only 9 mole. This implies, what can I conclude from this? B is not limiting reagent, or this implies A is limiting reagent. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That's okay, na? A will be the limiting reagent. So A is the limiting reagent and B will be the excess reagent. Aur kya calculate karna hai humko? You need to calculate how much of the excess reagent that is left, how much of C and D produced. Once you know the limiting reagent, do analysis with respect to that. Yeah, from the stoichiometry. 3 mole A reacts with how many mole B?
Six mole B.
So, how many mole of A taken? 9 mole, na? If it is the limiting reagent, the entire of 9 moles must be consumed. Kitna lagega? 9/3 × 6, which is equal
18.
To
18
mole B consumed. So B left. Kitna hai? 27 − 18?
9.
Which is equals to 9 mole. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is for analysis of B. Now do the similar analysis for the formation of C and D. Teen ke liye teen ban rahe. From the stoichiometry, 3 mole A gives you 3 mole C. Kitna mole A react kar rahe? 9 mole A will give you
9 mole C.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. From the stoichiometry, 3 mole 3 is giving you 5, na? Matlab kya hua? 3 mole A gives me 5 mole D. Abhi kitna mole react kar rahe? 9 mole A ke liye kitna milega? 9/3 × 5, which is equal to
15 mole D.
15 mole D. Agya, you are left with yes. 9 mole of B, you have formed 9 mole of C, and you have formed 15 mole of D. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is what you do in general. You will be assuming one of the reactant as a limiting reagent, the other reactant will become excess reagent. If our assumption is true, wahi rahega. If the assumption is false, the other reactant will be the limiting reagent. Is that clear? Okay. This is okay. This particular method is fine if you are having only 2 reactants. Suppose if you are having 3 reactants, if you are having 4 reactants, tab kya hoga? You need to always assume one of them as the limiting reagent. Wo nahi hai to dusre ko assume karo, wo bhi nahi hai to teesra wala ho jayega. 3 reactants ke case mein. Agar 4 hai to pehle ek assume karo, nahi hai to dusra assume karo. Ye sab karna padega na hame. Okay, so rather than doing this, we have a method. In that method, what we do is, we will calculate K. What is this K? K equals to given moles. Remember, you need to substitute moles, not given grams. Given moles upon stoichiometric coefficient. Calculate K for all reactants What is K? Given moles upon stoichiometric coefficient. Everyone, please put your video on. Given moles upon stoichiometric coefficient. Okay. Reactant with lower K will be the limiting reagent. But reactant with lower value of K. Is limiting reagent. Other reactants become excess reagents. Clear hai? Okay. Iske alawa, you need to also calculate for the reactants reacted and further products produced amounts na reacted or produced amounts will be equal to you just need to multiply the k of the limiting reagent ka jo bhi k rahega with the stoichiometric coefficient K of the limiting reagent with stoichiometric coefficient. Everyone, this is the method by which we will calculate which is the limiting reagent. And once you are done with the limiting reagent, you need to calculate how much amount of the excess reagent is left and how much amount of products are produced. Uske liye kya karna hai? The amount reacted or produced equal to K of the limiting reagent into stoichiometric coefficient. I will show you a question. Aapko samajh mein aa jayega. See this question. I am taking 21 mole of A and 24 mole of B. I need to calculate which is the excess reagent, which is the limiting reagent, amount of excess reagent left, amount of CND produced. Sabse pehle aapko karna kya hai? You need to calculate K. What is K? Given moles 21 upon stoichiometric coefficient is 7. Kitna hai? 3 hua. Iska given moles 24. डिवाइड बाय स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट इज 6 कितना है 4 हुआ ओके व्हिच इज हैविंग लोअर वैल्यू ऑफ के 3 ना
यस
सो दिस इज नथिंग बट के ऑफ द लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट एंड दिस बिकम्स द लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट दिस बिकम्स द एक्सेस रिएजेंट ओके उसके बाद क्या करेंगे वी विल कैलकुलेट द रिएक्टेड अमाउंट्स जो R है R indicates the reacted amounts. Reacted amounts are nothing but you need to multiply K of the limiting reagent with stoichiometric coefficient. K of the limiting reagent is 3, stoichiometric coefficient is 7. For reactants, as they are getting consumed, use negative sign. For the products, as they are being produced, we will be using positive sign. So reacted amount of A is minus 3 into 7. Reacted amount of B will be minus 3 into 6. You need to use the same K. K of the limiting reagent into stoichiometric coefficient. C produced will be plus 3 into 3. D produced will be plus 3 into 4. Okay. Finally, we will be mentioning the final amounts. Final amounts are nothing but initial plus the reacted. Initial kitna liya hai? 21. Reacted kitna hai? 20, minus 21 hai na? So, kitna hua? 0. Yahan pe detail mein likhna hai to, aapko 21 minus 21, which is equals to 0. Yahan pe 24 minus 18, equals to 6 mole. Yahan pe initially they are 0. सो फाइनल कितना है 9 मोल एंड दिस विल बी 12 मोल. अंडरस्टूड द मेथड हाउ टू डू?
यस सर.
बाकी लोग?
यस सर.
ओके फर्स्ट यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट.
यस सर.
गुड फर्स्ट यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट के. व्हाट इज के? Given moles upon stoichiometric coefficient. Once you do that, you will know what is the limiting reagent. For reacted amounts, it is K of the limiting reagent into stoichiometric coefficient with negative sign. For produced amounts, it is K of the limiting reagent into corresponding stoichiometric coefficients with a positive sign. Produced is a positive, reacted is a negative. The final amount is nothing but initial plus the reacted. Is that clear? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So use the same and try to solve these questions. Solve this question. Answer. Answer anyone? Everyone in the lecture, this is the last question. Please tell me the answer. We will continue
yes,
tomorrow's
sir.
Lecture. K kya hoga iske liye? 20 upon 2,
10.
Which is
10.
25 upon 3, which is 8 point something. So this is clearly K of the limiting reagent?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So this is limiting reagent and this becomes excess reagent in order to calculate the reacted moles. Kya karna padega? Kya karna hai? Reacted is equals to K of the limiting reagent
25
into 2 stoichiometric coefficient. Minus 25 by 3 into 3 plus 25 by 3
into 4
plus 25 by 3
into
1.
Into 1.
Okay. So final kya hoga? This is 20 minus 50 by 3. ये तो जीरो हो जाएगा, लिमिटिंग रिएजेंट है, जीरो आना भी चाहिए. दिस इज 100 बाई 3, दिस इज 25 बाई 3, सो विच इज इक्वल्स टू 10 बाई 3. सही है ना? 10 बाई 3 मोल ऑफ ए इज लेफ्ट, 100 बाई 3 मोल ऑफ सी इज फॉर्म्ड, 25 by 3 mole of D is also formed. Okay. I hope this method is clear to everyone. I will post this particular sheet. I'll post this particular note. Solve these two questions as homework. Okay. We will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. We will meet in tomorrow's lecture.